Hi guys, I think you guys can hear me. My name is Felipe Santiago. I'm the owner and furniture artist of Santiago's Furniture and Interior Art. So I'm here weekly, I started last week, and I'm doing my lives every week on Mondays. Say hello if you're here, I think Instagram is telling me that, you know, you guys are being notified. So whoever is with me, say hello whenever you can. Coffee. If you guys can hear me. Okay, perfect. I got one joined already. Thank you for following me. So today I'm gonna do a decoupage and table. As I said before, on last week, I said that I would show you guys on what I do, what I usually do with the decoupage. I'm also gonna let you guys know the difference between the decoupage papers that are out there in the market today. So, as you guys know, I'm an official content creator of Redesign with Prima, and they just did a new release of the decoupage fibers, and a lot of people don't know the difference of the old decoupager, which is like the mulberry paper, the rice paper, and there is a difference between them, and I'm just gonna explain briefly what they look like, and it's up to you guys to use. The good thing of Redesign with Prima, it's a company where give us furniture artists the ability to expand our creativity, and they're developing so many different products that give us the chance to actually do a lot of stuff with them. So I have here the new arrival. This is part of the recent release that we had last month, end of last month, which is aged patina. It's a decoupage fiber. So this one here, it's a lightweight. It's a lightweight decoupage fiber, and it's very strong. As even though it's thinner than the other decoupage papers, look how gorgeous this aged patina is. It's everything. Look, it's just highly pigmented. It's absolutely gorgeous. I love this. Yeah, so this is the fiber. The decoupage fiber is thinner than the regular decoupage papers, and it's a very lightweight. So I recommend when you're using those decoupage fibers, Redesign with Prima has a decoupage gel. This is the decoupage gel. It comes in a matte finish and a shine finish. Hi girl, Versi Charmed Restored. Hi girl. So this one here is the decoupage gel matte finish. There's also the shine one. Don't like much. I don't like to use the shine things, but it's amazing. I like the texture, the consistency of this one here. It's the decoupage gel. So I do use that a lot. But I also have this one here, which is the 3D Matte Gel. This one here is for heavyweight papers. I love this one here because when and I usually use on heavy traffic furniture, like for example, the top of that sideboard over there, or this one here. So that's what I'm gonna be doing today. So I give it a coat of Phenomena paint. I already explained to you guys, it's a Canadian paint. It's called Phenomena paint. And it's in the color of Maritime Hills, right here. So it's a nice, kind of like a bluish green. So I just gave it one coat, and it's a nice coverage actually. Like one coat, it was like completely covered, so which is good. Yeah, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use decoupage on top. This is an end table from the 70s. Love it. I love this style. Like it's just like thin, straight legs. Like it's really cool. So that was from the 70s. Love it. So yeah, coming back to the papers. So this is the decoupage fiber. That was a new released from last month. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's lightweight. And it's a smoother finish too. Like you hardly see like wrinkles and stuff like that. It's minimum to none actually. I used it like as you saw in Serene Thought. That was the name of the decoupage fiber used for the release. And no wrinkles. Like really, really nice. And it's cheaper. It's way cheaper than the regular decoupage papers. It's like a huge price difference and worth it to try. Like, worth it to try. So, this is actually one of the first releases of the Redesign with Primo with decoupage papers. So this one here is the decoupage rice paper. This is a heavyweight, like it's thicker than the fiber, way thicker. But also, that's a good thing too. It's like, it's higher, the quality is the same, it's great quality. But this one here, I would use heavy traffic, like pieces. Like I would use that with no problem at all. This is like thicker. This is thicker. I would not use a decoupage. You can use this, absolutely. You can use the decoupage gel. But I prefer, in my opinion, as a furniture artist, I prefer to use the 3D matte gel. Because this one here, it's for thicker papers. This one here literally dries like cement. Like, it's very nice. Like, I love this one here. So, you have two options. I have so many options that Redesign with Prima, but this one here I would use more like in a, you know, the fiber decoupage, or this one, you can either or, you can use both of them. But this one here for high traffic, you know, pieces, I would use this one. High traffic surfaces, I use this one here. This is my preference. And yeah, so this was the first release. Like a year, I'd say a year and a half ago. This one is called Moment Family or something like that. But this one here is, I need to find a place to actually start this decoupage because I actually love this one here. But it's highly pigmented, as you see. You don't see much through it, like the fiber. So I would actually, when you're painting your furniture, with this one here, you can paint pretty much any color and you won't see through it. But with the fiber, I would try to get like, if you wanna like a color close to the patina, like for example, I would go with like a dark navy blue, like you can see more of the details and stuff like that. You can see a little bit of me through it. So it's a thinner, lightweight, decoupage. So for this end table, I'm gonna be using, okay, so that's just the difference, guys. Like, I just wanted you to show you that, like, you know, the decoupage rice paper mulberry like paper, that's what they call. It's a thicker paper. They're both very strong, very strong. This is more expensive. This one here is way more expensive than the new release, which is the fiber, which I love it because Redesign with Prima is giving you like the option of, like, you know what I mean? Like, of if you're on a budget, which is the same quality. If you have a bit of extra money and you want to use these ones here in a high traffic surface, go for it. But these are the difference. So with this one here, I like to use the 3D Matte Soft Gel because it's a thicker consistency, like, and it dries faster than the decoupage gel, and it dries like a cement, like it's very strong. This one here for lightweight, like decoupage, or even for stronger, but I would like actually, excuse me, I would like give it like a little bit of a thicker layer when you're applying that on your furniture than this one here. This one here, the thinner, the better. All right, so these are the two difference. Hopefully I'll get the chance to do this next month because I love this 8. This is gorgeous, gorgeous pattern. All right. So the one I'm gonna use on this small end table is called Andressa. Hopefully I'm, you know, pronouncing the right thing, but it's called Andressa. It's a small decoupage tissue paper, which is very similar to the fiber. It's thin, lightweight, very strong too. And it's a floral, like a vintage floral pattern. Like, it's gorgeous. I love that. And I think it would match really well with the kind of like blue green like that I'm using here. So just for you guys to have an idea. So you see the thin, like the tissue, this is a small size. It's not an A1. A1 is 23 by 33 inches. This one here should be 19 by 30 roughly. So these are more like for small projects, which is perfect for this one here. So that's what I'm trying to do. I'm just going with this small decoupage, but this one is, I know, it's gorgeous. It's a gorgeous, like, vintage floral pattern. So love it. Most of the time it comes like, when it comes in a package, it comes like, you know, folded like this. So you see, and you're just like, oh my gosh, like, how am I gonna get rid of those lines, right? The folding lines. Usually it will smoother out like it by itself. Once you start applying the decoupage on your piece, you will even out. Like, you know, these lines, it won't show. But no matter of a doubt, I just literally use a steamer. I got one at, you know, here at the thrift store. I got one at a thrift store, like this, literally, like a small, it was literally, this still has, oh, still has a price, it's $7, love it. So, you just give it like a quick steam on it, like, you know what I mean, like, same thing as you were ironing your clothes. I'm gonna do it now, actually, so you guys can see it. Nothing really rough, like, you know, it's decoupage, it as I said, like, it's lightweight, but it's still very strong paper. I need to find an outlet. One sec. Just found one. Yeah, so this one here, it's lightweight, but it's very strong, see? Can you hear it? It's actually like, it feels like fabric. It does feel like fabric. So I'm just waiting a little bit so this steamer can just like get hotter. All right, so the tools that I needed, the tools I need for this, love my hair. Anyway, so the tools I need for this, I can consider that like a high traffic, you know, surface. So I'm gonna go, you can go with either or, but I'm gonna go with the 3D Matte Gel, like, I like this one. So I'm gonna go with this one. See, it's very, so you can see it. Trying to show it, like, there you go. So it's a very thick, creamy consistency, but very smooth gel. I need, okay. I call this wallpaper squeegee. Some people, I don't know what they call, but I call it wallpaper squeegee. And yeah, it really helps you, like with the wrinkles and everything, really helps. And to eliminate the bubbles and air inside, I just use like a bit of wrapping plastic on it, like furniture wrapping plastic or something like that. The same ones that I use to wrap my furniture. All right, so can you see it? Like it's teamy now. So I'm just gonna go, see? Just trying to eliminate those folding lines and make sure that it's just nice and even. You don't need a lot. See, look way better now. Make sure. Get rid of that. To make also the process easier of like, you know, applying the decoupage on your furniture. And again, you don't have to do this. I just don't want any wrinkles or lines showing, so I'm good. I'm very perfectionist, okay? Details, details, details. All right, so let's find now. I'm just gonna turn my camera to the end table so we can see it. And I'll show you how, like, I didn't finish painting. I just painted, actually, the area that I wanted to show you how to apply the decoupage here. I want to make sure you guys can see it. It's one of the big roses to be. So good. Look,
How gorgeous. See, high quality, high like pigmentation, like it's really nice. So what I'm gonna do, I'll make sure I get a nice pattern here, because that's where the you know, the decoupage will be shown more. I like this side too. Oh, it's just so gorgeous. Oh, I like this one. I like this side. Is there like, you know, here's a blue here, yellow. This side. Okay. I kind of like this better. All right. So I usually apply the gel with a cheap brush. I bought this brush at Michael's, but it was like very, it wasn't clearance. You can also get those brushes at dollar store for sure. I wouldn't use my expensive brushes on that. No. You can also use one of those foam brushes. That works too. Okay. So, I think I got this right side. They're both the same size. Yeah, I don't know if probably wants this side. So I have decided what side I'm gonna be using. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna get my 3D matte gel. Have your brush in. And I divided my decoupage when I'm applying by sections. So I start like very, small section here, and then I will move off with that. I don't use a lot of the matte gel because I know it's a very strong gel. So I place it on. And with my squeegee from the center to the sides, I smooth that out. And I'll get my piece of plastic, like furniture wrapping plastic, and I'll just like smooth it out until it's fully on. No wrinkles whatsoever, like there's no wrinkles at all. Perfect. Alright. Make sure that I have more paper. Yeah, same thing, just smoothing. Make sure there's no wrinkles, which you don't need a lot of effort. Like the coupage papers from Rizan with Creamer are absolutely incredible, so you don't need a lot of work to remove wrinkles or air bubbles. So so this side here is because there's like legs in it, like it's two level end table, so I'm just gonna do a cut here to make sure. That I have all the decoupage on the bottom part. Sorry guys, I'm just cutting the edges here so I can, I'll make sure that I'll be able to have it in the whole surface. So same here. Oops, I think I put a little too much. Make sure that you have like the decoupage there everywhere. If you can't, and there are parts that like it, there are parts that you can just literally paint after.
So make sure there's no wrinkles.
That your surface is absolutely smooth. Yeah, this table here is a little bit of a challenge because it's not a flat, it's a flat surface, but there's a lot of rounded corners where I have, you know, cut and make sure that the decoupage is actually placed correctly. So now, you see the decoupage is on, so I got everything, it's actually glued on the table. Then, to make sure so another thing too. So once you have everything glued on the table, I do another layer of the decoupage gel or the 3D matted gel on top. So that it's a thin layer just to make sure that it won't come out and it gives that extra protection to the paper. This is not my last coat. This is my final coat. After this, I'm gonna sand it a little bit just to smooth a little bit the surface. And then once I have everything painted and done, I will use my top coat just to give that extra protection and against scratches, like, you know, water spills and everything, so. So I'll make sure that, you know, everything is sealed. And it should, because this is a high traffic surface. So people will place things on top of it. And I will make sure that that won't damage the image, like the paper. If you spill the coffee here or anything like that, right? Because, for example, it's an end table, so you're placing things on it. So what if, like, you know, you knock it over? So you don't want to do that. You don't want to damage your piece of art. So you need to seal it after. That's why most of the time, I'd say 90%, 80% of the time, I don't use wax. Furniture wax, I use a top coat. Most of my pieces have top coat. Like, I'm like hardly ever use wax. It's just a preference. A lot of people use waxes. I just don't. You see, guys, like, this is very easy. Like, there's no wrinkle at all. No wrinkle. Like, there's no wrinkles here. Like, it's just, it looks like I just painted the entire piece, like, by hand. Like, hand painted.
This side is done. It's looking good. Thing to do up here. And once you seal it, you can just paint on top of it. You can paint, you can use moldings, you can do whatever you want.
So with this end table here, I was thinking about, like, you know, painting green, like use some gold accents, like it's very trendy now, like any sort of green, like especially the emerald green, it's very trendy with some gold accents, like very, very trendy. Sorry guys, I'm just finishing here sealing the decoupage. Just making sure everything's sealed. And a lot of people think, like, oh, what about the brush strokes? I was like, yeah, but like once this is dry, I'll sand it, like with a 220 or 320 sandpaper, and it will smooth it out a little bit. Alright. So this is done. This is all sealed. Okay. And a lot of, like, what do you do with the, you know, the extra decoupage paper here? So, I can't do it now because it's wet, but what I do, I got a sand block and I start, like, you know, sanding the corners, and the paper will start tearing, and then you just, like, you know, have it, the way you want. So you guys can see, it's looking pretty nice. And yeah, so again, so I just showed you guys on how to use the decoupage paper, decoupage tissue paper from Redesign with Prima. This one I'm using, it's called Andressa. It's part of the new release last month. End of last month we had the new release, and this is part of the new release. It's a small decoupage tissue paper, all Andressa, and I also showed the difference of the decoupage fiber, which is the new decoupage paper, decoupage fiber from Redesign with Prima. This one is the A1 aged patina. It's gorgeous, beautiful, love this one as well. I think I have more here. And I'll show you, I showed you the difference between the old ones, like not the old ones, but these ones are the first release. This one is a different decoupage paper. It's more heavyweight decoupage, but highly pigmented too. Very nice. And I got, this one is part of the new release. gilded lace. Beautiful. It's also decoupage fiber. This is an A1. This is 23 by 33. It's gorgeous. There's some like honeycombs here. It's like a gold-ish like kind of pattern. Like with some grass, I think. Some grass and flowers. Yeah, it's gorgeous, this one here. It's very nice. Very trending too, like, but you can see the honeycombs here. It's very nice. So this one is part of the new release as well, of the decoupage, A1 decoupage fiber. Way cheaper than the other decoupages. It's half of the price, literally. This is also part of the new release, antique laces. This is very nice. It's gorgeous. It's like vintage, like flower pattern. I'm gonna open. I'll show you. My end table is looking pretty. She's so cute. I'm using Andressa, the small decoupage tissue paper from the new release last month. So this one here, it's called Antique Laces, part of the new release, A1 decoupage fiber. Oh, look, this is, oh, look at the antique laces and vintage flowers. This is gorgeous. There's also kind of like a honeycomb like background. It looks like very, quite similar to the one I showed you, like the other ones. This one here is gorgeous. I can't wait to put my hands on those. Can't wait to start. Okay, this one, I have more here. Oh, I got more, I didn't even know. Okay, so this one here is Serene Wilderness. Oh, first thing when I open that for you. We're just having tea with Felipe Santiago. Okay. So this one is also A1 decoupage fiber. See how thin, but very strong. Thin and strong. Loves it. Okay, so this one is very nice. This one is cool. This one gives me a lot of ideas with texture. And you can also add another good thing too. With decoupage, you can add... So these are transfers. Completely different. So Breton with Prima also has transfers. And these are the most famous. A lot of people know transfers. So I love playing with this. I love playing with both. Or sometimes I love adding moldings too. I love the molds. So these are the silicone molds. So these are the silicone molds. And I love adding on the decoupage. Like, That's what I love the most every time with my decoupage papers. You can add on stuff. Like, you can just be so creative. Like, you just... Amazing. I love that. So, yeah. So, I love how, like, this one here, you can just, you know, play with texture around it and maybe some transfers. I have some fellow artists who did that. They added like some transfers, like roses here around it. Gorgeous. Gorgeous. All right, so I was just showing you what you actually can do with the decoupage fibers. Like, it's just versatile. Like, it's very nice. All right, so this one here is called serene wilderness.
Okay.
So this one here. Oh, this one is cool. Whale and Cosmos. Really nice. Really nice. I can't wait to put my hands on that too. Like, I have actually so many ideas with those ones. Like, they're really cool. So this one here is also an A1 decoupage fiber. Part of the new release. Oh, look at this. Oh, look at those stars and those colors. This is gorgeous. This is really cool. This is really, that would look amazing on a dresser. Like, look. Just the lady riding a whale in his space. Like, it's, don't explain me how they come up like with this idea, but I'm totally on board. Like, that's me. This is me. Like, I don't know where I'm going for, but like when I do, it's just gorgeous. Gorgeous look. And there's a big moon here. This is really nice. Probably one of my favorites. Yeah, so that's it for now. I'm just gonna summarize here a little bit of what I did today. So I used a small decoupage tissue paper from Redesign with Prima called Andressa. It's part of the new release. On this beautiful antiques from the 70s end table. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna, I place that on with the 3D matte gel from Redesign with Prima. I'm just waiting to dry so I can eliminate those corners with my sanding block. It literally just sanded the corners, so those edges will start tearing apart. So that's good. It's all placed on. I painted the piece in maritime like hills. It's part of the Phenomena paints. It's a Canadian paint. All the links will be at the end of this video, the live video. I always post the links if you want to buy their products. You're more than welcome. I get a little bit of a commission. So if you love it, go ahead, click on the link, and you can purchase. Yeah, and I'll see you guys next week, Monday at 3 p.m. local time, Newfoundland time. Just remember that Newfoundland in Canada has its own time. So yeah, my name is Felipe Santiago. I'm like the owner and furniture artist of Santiago's Furniture and Interior Art. Love you guys. Stay tuned. Have a great day. And I can't wait to show you my 70s end table look. Love you.